Good morning, friends and investors. Welcome to the pre-market update. As we know that yesterday markets were a little negative, 1% down in terms of Nifty and Sensex are concerned on the back of the exit polls coming for the Bihar election, assembly election results. On top of it, if you look at the FII, DII data and the cash and index futures data, in the FII segment, they have sold around 858 crores, FIIs have sold, whereas in cash segment, they have bought around 35 crores and DII have bought around 75 crores in the cash segment. European markets were very much mixed bag because CAC and DAX were little 3.3% to 0.6% higher, whereas FTSE, the UK market, was little lower in terms of trades were concerned. But the US markets were more or less flattish with a negative bias, and SGX Nifty is suggesting a positive opening of around 14 points, because the kind of exit polls we have got yesterday is one of the exit polls indicating to BJP or the NDA's majority, whereas the two of the exit polls indicating to the Grand Alliance majority, whereas the rest of the three polls were suggesting a mixed bag or a hung assembly. So these kind of a reviews, so I would not say that this time the today's market would give a big time gap up or a gap down, but volatility will persist and we would be waiting for the actual result on Sunday, which will be reflected in the markets on Monday. So overall, we should be waiting for the Sunday result and take a call. But overall, if any dip is there in the markets because of the adverse reactions, I think that would be a good buying opportunity.
Good morning, friends. I will give analysis on derivatives. Taking cues from the international markets, our markets also open on a flattish note, but thereon we have seen a constant selling pressure in Nifty in yesterday's trading session, and throughout the day it remained under a selling zone, and we have seen market breadth also continue to remain on a negative side, due to which in the last 1 hour of trade we have seen Nifty breaking its important support of 8000, which was a bit surprising for us too. We were not anticipating 8000 to go, but in yesterday's trading session we have seen Nifty closing below 8000 odd levels at 7989.40 with a loss of around 1 odd percentage. The open interest terms 2.5 odd percentage was built up in open interest, that is 5 lakh shares were added in open interest. However, cost of carry did increase from 6% to 7.5 odd percentage, that is Nifty premium did came up from 28-29 odd points to 32 odd points currently. While the put call ratio have been lower by more 2 basis points in yesterday's trading session from 0.89 to 0.86. So majority of the activity in yesterday's trading session has been on the shorter side. We have seen Nifty showing good amount of build-up in open interest, especially Bank Nifty, which has seen an addition of around 7 odd percentage, have also seen shorts getting build-up into it, and the momentum in the market favors on the negative side. Indian volatility index have surprisingly, Indian volatility index have inched lower, and it is now down by around 0.5 percentage from 19.36 to 19.29 levels. On the option side, 8100 call option, 200 and 300 all have seen a heavy pileup of open interest. 8100 and 200 continues to add significant amount of open interest since start of this expiry, and has been on the resistance and can see strip resistance around or the over that level. While in the put option, 7800 have seen an addition of around 7 odd percentage, dominates the put strike price. It's now the it continues to be the highest in terms of open interest, while 8000 put option have seen and have continues to see reduction in open interest of around 4 odd percentage, and it's now the second highest in terms of open interest. So all in all, studying the options activity and the open interest in the futures, we feel the momentum in the market favors on the negative side. Today, on the Sunday, we have been heading towards a major event of the election verdict, and post that we might see some kind of selling pressure if the verdict is not at all favorable for the market. There are no securities in bank period for today's trade. On FIIs terms, they have sold in index futures, but still they have not built a significant amount of positions in index futures. They have sold of around 858 odd crores, and majority of their selling has been on the back of the long unwinding, as the open interest was just up by 1%. since they have been net selling by such a huge figure, if the open interest is up by only 1%, it indicates the majority of the selling came from the long and winding part. Index options, surprisingly, they have been net selling with a huge amount. Remember, friends, in the start of this series, we have seen FIIs have been buying index options in a big quantity, especially in the first 2 days of the expiry. But now we have seen FIIs have been squaring off their options long positions, since they are net sellers by around 2,181 odd crores. And the open interest of an index options of FIIs went down by around 300 to 400%. So indicating long unwinding was been clearly visible in the index options, and majority of the buildups in the start of the expiry we have seen on the put options. So it has been like they have been squaring off the put options, and they don't want to take any kind of speculative positions ahead of the event. Stock futures, there were net sellers of 1072 odd crores, while stock options are net sellers of 35 crores. So all in all, there were net sellers in most of the segments on the FIIs front. On the market level, 5 days we have stands at 8060 with a lower range at 7950 and higher range at 8060. SIX Nifty has been trading positive, taking mixed views from the international markets. It's been about to open on a positive note due to the favorable event which came on the discounts policy. We might see Nifty opening up with 18% gain, and SIX Nifty is currently quoting at around 7990. That's it from derivatives. Thank you.
Now let's look at today's trading ideas. The first idea of the day is Tata Steel at CNP 225. The Q2 operating performance below market expectations. So on top of it, profits were at 1,1528.7 crores versus the estimate of 229 crores on a consolidated basis. And the other income was 2,938 crores versus the 321 crores. That's why the profits were up on a consolidated basis. So the results all in all was not good. So action to be taken is short Tata Steel. Stop loss at 229 and target at 219-216. Polaris, the second idea of the day, is at CNP 204. The Virtusa will purchase the shares of 220.73 each, aggregating to 1173 crores. It will also make an open offer to the public shareholders of Polaris to purchase up to additional 26%. Action to be taken is long Polaris. Stop loss 200, target 210-214. The third stock of the day is Glenmark Pharma at CMP 2966. Glenmark Pharma gets US FDA nod for betamethasone, diprofenac, and calamazone. It treats inflammatory and pruritic manifestation. Action to be taken is long Glenmark. Short stop loss at 947, target 994-1014. We'll look at the news updates for today. Is Torrent Pharma's new plant at the Dahej starts operation. IDFC Bank to debut on browsers today with few branches in the network. Tips industry to buy back shares up to rupees 70 per share. Broadcasting funds form Sun TV Network Limited board of directors met on 5th November 2015 to evaluate the proposal for buyback of equity shares of company. Sun TV Network has been reported in the BSE filings. Sales of new Volkswagen cars in Britain slumped by almost 10% last month in the wake of pollution cheating scandal. Industry data showed today. Cabinet clears $7 billion reform package to boost discounts, that is distribution companies. Exit poll is as divided on Bihar, 4 gives Nitish and Lalu, majority 1 gives NDA sweep. GSW Group plans to invest 4,000 crores, that is $610 million, to boost its port and cement capacity in the next 2 years. Cabinet clears the reform package to boost discounts, as we have known earlier. Also, we've discussed refinance existing loss with 75% of debt to taken over the next 2 years. Turnaround of discounts over next 2 to 3 years. States accountable to fund losses in graded manner. Expect positive reaction in REC, PFC, NTPC and certain PSU banks. Result updates, if you look at, Cipla has posted quite a good set of numbers in terms of PAT is concerned. 431 crores versus 299 crores on a YOY basis. whereas the profit jumps 44% on exports, domestic business little bit in a slowdown basis. Talwarkar's Q2 numbers were out 24.9% higher at 24.6 crores versus 19.67 crores on a YOY basis. Castrol India Limited posted a 21.5% increase in profit after tax at Rs. 143.2 crores from July-September 2015 against 117.9 crores during the same period in the previous year. Trent Q2 earnings were also out PAT at 13.44 crores versus 11.43 crores, which was 17.6% higher. Sales was at 376 crores versus 350 crores, up 7.4% on a YOY basis. Results which are going to come out for today is Triveni Turbines, where the expectation in the PAT estimates are 27.1 crores, Gateway District Park at 49 crores, IL&FS Transportation at 106 crores, Info Edge Limited at 37.4 crores, GSK Consumer at 189.5 crores, M&M at 951 crores, Rico Auto Industry at 5 crores. The other results which are going to come today is Tata Motors, 2100 crores is the PAT estimate, Action Motor at 261 crores, Aurobindo Pharma at 465.1 crores, BHEL at 130 crores, State Bank of India, which is a major result today, at 3710.2 crores, Punjab National Bank, the second biggest PSU banking, with an estimate of 973.8 crores, Bank of Baroda 1089.7 crores. The stocks to look out for with a positive bias are Reliance Capital at 422 rupees, Coal India at 337 rupees, stocks to see at with a negative bias in Tata Steel, as we have been short also, at CMP 226, Sun Pharma 821, Jubilant Foodworks at 13.8. Stocks for investments are Aurobindo, Aditya Birla Nuvo 2016, Maruti 4527, HDFC Bank 1080, Tata Motors DVR at 266, Z Entertainment at 406. Thank you, friends, and happy investing.